Next speaker is Lindsey German from Counterfire and also convener for the Stop the War Coalition.
Thank you very much, and I'm very pleased to be speaking here tonight at a meeting which actually talks about what is really going on in the European Union and what it really means for working people, because the whole narrative that has grown up in recent months over this question of the referendum and whether we should leave or remain in the EU is a narrative that if you are left-wing, if you are in support of women's rights, if you're anti-racist, if you're in support of workers' rights, you have to be in favour of Remain. And if, as well, David Cameron now tells us, if you don't want any war in Europe, you have to be in favour of Remain. He obviously didn't notice there was a very significant war in Europe in the 1990s in Yugoslavia, caused in part by the pressure that the EU countries put on the various disintegrating bits of Yugoslavia. He obviously didn't remember either, because history isn't its strong point. There was a war, the French colonial war in Algeria, but let's leave these minor questions aside. This is the sort of narrative that they're giving us. Now, as previous speakers have said, and I don't want to repeat the points that they've made, which I very much agree with, this is a lie, that actually the European Union is not for more democracy, for more equality, for more freedom, for anti-racism. It's actually for exactly the opposite. But if you look at what it is doing, the European Union is driving a number of things. When we talk about workers' rights, for example, and Rob referred to collective bargaining. Collective bargaining is getting weaker across Europe, not just in this country. It's getting weaker in France, it's getting weaker in Germany. We were hoping to have a French speaker tonight. I don't know whether he'll be arriving, but people may not have noticed, because you won't have heard very much about it in the British media. There is a massive strike wave going on in France, precisely over the neoliberals' reforms that the Hollande government wants to impose on French working people. In other words, what is happening to Europe is it is all becoming more neoliberal. People's wages are being driven down. People's conditions are getting worse. People's rights and security is getting worse. So the idea this is a protection against attacks on our rights in Britain is absolutely false. It's also false to say that it is doing anything for women's rights. As Brid has pointed out, abortion is still not available north or south in Ireland. And yet, this is supposed to be something that is a fundamental principle of women's rights, equality and so on in the European Union. Racism is running amok in countries like the Czech Republic, like Slovakia, like Hungary, in all of these places. There are no sanctions at all put on the racist and far-right governments in these countries to try to stop them. There are sanctions on Greece, for which are attacking them over the economic policies. There are absolutely no sanctions on the political attacks on people that are going on. If you look at what is happening with democracy in the European Union, we're told that we have the right to elect members of the European Parliament every 5 years. What people don't tell you is that they're about as useless, they're elected, but they're about as useless as the House of Lords, which you saw in such splendour today. Now, it's always difficult if you live in Britain to try and talk about British democracy as something superior to any other democracy when you have a 90-year-old unelected monarch and when you have a House of Lords, which is... The House of Lords is even bigger than the House of Commons, astonishingly. It's so big they can't seat all the Lords in it, so some of them have to kind of sit out and not be allowed in it. But the crucial principle about democracy in this country, imperfect as it is that we do have the right to elect governments, and we do have the right to elect governments that can do something to change things. And this is something which we don't have in the European Union. There is absolutely no basis for doing it. And, of course, the final argument, and I think the argument that touches most of us as socialists and as people on the left in this country, is, of course, the argument about immigration. I mean, I personally believe that anybody should have the right to live anywhere that they want to in the world. I think it's a basic human right. But the truth is, this isn't true of the European Union, and it's certainly not true of the people who live outside of the European Union. In fact, the other side of free movement of labour, which in any case is now being restricted by the barriers and the walls that are going up across Europe and the tear gas that is being used against the refugees, the other side of it is fortress Europe. That if you are from the Middle East, if you are from Africa, if you are from India or Pakistan, you have less ability to get into this country than you had before we were in the EU. Now, I'm in favour of free movement, and I'm in favour of free movement for everybody, but actually, what this fortress Europe is doing, what the attacks on the refugees are doing, what all those things are doing, is actually fueling a growth of the far right and a growth of racism, which is exactly the opposite of what people say the EU is setting out to do. We have far right parties across Europe who are growing in Germany and France, in countries like that, and the European Union is only making that situation worse. The deal that they did over Turkey is a complete breach with any previous international law since the Second World War. It is an absolute shame to humanity, and it's something that we should not accept as something which is part of the kind of continent that we want to live in. The left who would agree with a lot of what we're saying here on the platform, but their argument is, and Paul Mason put it very, very succinctly in The Guardian yesterday, their argument is the EU's terrible, it's neoliberal, it's smashing up Greece. By the way, it's postponed smashing up Spain and Portugal until after this referendum and until after the Spanish elections, but then they will turn around and do that as well. What they're saying is, then you can't do this. Everything you say about Europe is true, but we can't leave. Why? Because we will have Boris Johnson. Now, I don't quite get why Boris Johnson is so much worse than the rest of the Tories. And I don't see it. I don't see that he's worse than George Osborne or Theresa May or David Cameron or any of the others. They are all Tories and they all have a plan for what they want to do to us, which they're already doing, and whatever happens after the referendum, they will still try to do. But the truth is that a Leave vote will make it much harder for them to do it. It will make it much harder for the banks, it will make it much harder for big people. It will make it much harder for all of the people who say that they want a Europe which is good for business. And we know a Europe which is good for business is a Europe which is bad for workers. We've seen enough of that, and we know there's going to be even more of that. I also think that this argument about Boris Johnson is a kind of blackmail. That if you don't go along with these people, you'll get something even worse. Well, surely we should say what we believe, and surely we should be honest about what we think. And if we think the EU is worse for working people, then we have to stand up and say that it is worse for working people. We cannot lie to people about this. And when I read the TUC, I would have to call it propaganda, I'm sorry to say, that we wouldn't have equal pay or the 8-hour day or any of these things if it wasn't for the EU. It's complete rubbish and it's completely untrue. Everything that people have fought for, and there are massive differences within the EU, everything that people have got is what trade unions and other campaigns have fought for over generations in order, and that is the way. That what both sides want to do after June the 23rd. We know that if the Leave campaign win, we know they want, the people on the right, the Farages and Johnsons and Goves and all those people, they want to attack workers. But what do you think David Cameron's going to do if he wins on June the 23rd? Do you think he's going to scrap tuition fees? No, the Tories today said they're going to increase these. Do we think they're going to scrap the trade union bill and stop the even further restrictions on working people's rights that we've seen in this country over decades now by successive governments? Are they going to do all that? No, they're not. If they win a Remain vote, they will come back and attack us even harder. And the truth is, there is only one thing that will protect us from that. It's not Brussels, it's not Strasbourg, it isn't even the most left-wing MEP. It will be what ordinary working people do as part of their struggles, whether it's the junior doctors, the teachers, the university lecturers, whoever is going out on strike, whoever is fighting back over these issues. The only way that we will move forward in this country is by people fighting back. And let's just remember one thing. Jeremy Corbyn is now the leader of the Labour Party. I'm sorry that Labour is taking the position it is, because I think millions of people, Labour voters, are going to vote no, and I don't want them to be seen as useless. The vast majority, I think, are being castigated as UKIP supporters because this is supposed to be the only alternative. We have to have a left voice to say to those people, you can vote to leave, but you can do so from the left. It's not about turning your back on European workers, it's about uniting over the things that matter. And if Jeremy Corbyn wins an election in this country, he'll face massive opposition, as we know, from our own ruling class. But I'll tell you what, the European Union will be absolutely behind them in trying to enforce the Troika and everything else that we've seen in Ireland, we've seen in Greece, and we've seen elsewhere.